very much, Lady, on your table, Lady, to be fed by thee, and that is why we are praying that you tell us the story of Jesus. Speak to us, O God, in your own voice. Use me like your vessel. Speak to your people and explain your word to each and every one of us in the language that we are going to understand. And help us to be hearer and doer of your word. This we pray in the name of Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Have your seat. I want to take this again opportunity to welcome you. Karibu Canon, nimekuona uko hapa pamoja nasi tangu ile mambo ilitendeka ya kanisa kufungwa. Thank you very for coming back. We are here and you can see your seat, your pews. It is already there for you and Mama Jerry. Asanteni wote kwa kufika kwenu. Karibuni sana in our service. Praise the Lord. For the visitor, my name is Andrew Karaja, and this wonderful day, I'm very, very much grateful before you sharing the word of God together with you, and now I have the joy of salvation. Christ is the Lord in my soul, and my prayer is that step by step, he continue walking with me. Praise the Lord. The theme of the year, we have been introducing the theme of the year this month, and as you know, it is the become, advance, and possess. You can see the people are told to decamp from the tent so that they can go to the city that the Lord promised their forefather that he was going to give them, that beautiful city of Canaan, the city full of milk, full of honey, full of good fruits, the city that they had not built. They were told, break the camp and advance. Praise the Lord. As we break the camp and advance, today I have chosen our topic to be walking with the Lord. To be walking with the Lord. There is a singer who sang this song, when we walk with the Lord in the light office. That is what we are going to hear for the few minutes. If you read the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 1, and verse 6 and verse 7, you are going to see the people of Israel. God spoke to Moses and told him, tell the people to move from Horeb, where they were, break their camp and advance. The reading that was led by Mwalimu Mruko today, it started with that opening, that Moses was told by God to tell the people to move from Horeb, going to the promised land. This year, and today being the fourth Sunday, Lord, this month, I chose that to be our today's topic in order to continue learning how to walk with the Lord the whole of this year. And Moses, the Bible says, Moses was told, when you chose to walk with me, I will give you rest. I will give you rest by all signs. I will give you rest. When Moses was told to take the people of Israel to the promised land, and God spoke to him and told him, tell the people to rise up and move, Moses beseeched the Lord and told him, God, walk with us. But God disagreed with Moses and said, Moses, I won't go with you because the people, they disobeyed me, because the people, they are stiff-necked people. And so, if I walk with you, I will destroy you. On the way, I will destroy you because you are stiff-necked people, you disobeyed me, you broke my covenant. And therefore, Moses prayed with humility and requested God to walk with them in their journey. And God accepted in verse 18, from verse 16, 15 to verse 18, you are going to see how Moses had a conversation with God until he reminded him, you God, you promised me that there is one that you are going to walk with me, and I have not seen you. And now God decided, Moses, I will walk with you in your journey. Praise the Lord. As we do so, we are going to relate that reading and to relate that topic of the day, walking with God, with the life of this man by name Enoch. The man by name Enoch, you read it from the Genesis chapter 5 and chapter 6, together with his counterpart who was called Noah. But today, as we think about walking with God, we are going to reflect that reading or the life through the life of this man by name Enoch. When, as a Christian, we choose to walk with God, we should act differently, we should have a different life and shine brighter in our life, in our relationship with the other, and in our relationship with God. Because the longer we walk closely with God, the better we will know Him. And no way you can be able to know a person very good, or you can know a person in and out, unless you walk together in the same journey. When we have that close relationship with God, and we walk with Him, He will open our eyes as a Christian in course of the year. He will open our eyes so that we may continue knowing His will and His goodness in our life. So, as we think about walking with God this year, we need to ask ourselves, how is my relationship with Him? How do I know Him better? We may not have those many years like this man by name Enoch. But when we walk with God, His Spirit will be with us, and He will reveal His will, His wisdom, and His purpose for us in this life. What else was present? So we need to ask ourselves, who is this am I walking with? For 100 years, Enoch, he put God first in his life. Who is God in your life? Or God become number what in your life? But this man, Enoch, he put God first in his life. God is everything in his life, in terms of his thinking, in terms of his ways, in terms of his walk, how he conducted himself. God was number one. God was number one in his love. In his service to him, God was number one. In his worship, God was number one. Who is God in our life? And for Enoch, making God to be number one, he lived a very unique life. Praise the Lord. How is your life? How do you live? Whom are you walking with? As we begin this year, did you invite God in your life to walk with you, be it in your family, be it in your life, be it in your business, be it in your job? Did you release yourself fully to God so that He may walk with you? As we reflect through the life of Enoch, he lived a godly life. He lived a godly life, life which was full of faith, while he was being surrounded by a very evil people, when he was surrounded by a very evil world. He lived a life, a very different life. He differentiated himself with other people, and he said, even if they are not going to live according to the will of God, personally, I live through that will of God. The life of Noah, it was life full of complete trust in God's word. His life was in full, complete, trusting the word of God. It is through faith, that which was in him, that Noah was able to build an ark that saved many people. And he did so in a very completely a large locked place. It is through that life he did, Noah and Enoch, they did everything that God had asked them to do. He lived a very life which was completely full of obedience and faithfulness to God. Praise the Lord. He lived that life which was full of complete obedience and completely faithful to God, even though the circumstances that was surrounding him, it was different. But he chose to live that life. What is Jesus saying? Christians, this year, it is our time. We decide to walk with God. Despite what is surrounding us, as we are opening our ears, the political waves outside is very hot. Politicians, they are singing the issue of dynasty and hustler's nation. We need to be steadfast Christians. We need to stand firm as a Christian, because the dynasty nation and hustler's nation zinaweza zikatupotosha kwa njia tukaweza kusahau ule mwito tuliitwa na. Hello. We need to be focused. We need to live at that life, right? That life which was lived by this man was called Enoch. And because of faith and obedience and completely trusting in God, he walked with God for more than 365 years. What does that mean as a Christian to walk with God? What does that mean you as a Christian that we walk with God? This man Enoch, he lived a life that he was focusing on God despite what? He focused on God all the days of life, and he avoided anything that can distract his relationship with his God. He identified that this way, these people, this person can distract my relationship with God. And he lived a God life, focusing on God and avoiding any destruction that can distract his relationship with God. Exactly that is what it means for you and I to walk with God. Where do we focus? Where is our focus? In the course of the year, we need to live a focused life, focusing our eyes to where our destiny is, our call, where we are called. And we pray God to give a discerning spirit in order to know that things that can distract my relationship with God, or that can hinder God not to walk with me. As he told Moses, "Moses, I cannot go with you, because if I go with you, I will destroy all of you in the wilderness." And so, since the people disobeyed me and they are stiff-necked people, I will go with them. What is this that can distract my relationship with God in the course of the year? Number two, walking with God means that you are in agreement. You are in a full agreement with him. Amos chapter 3 and verse 3. The Bible says, no way two people can walk unless they agree. For you and I to walk with God, you must have an agreement with him. Have you agreed that you are going to walk with God as we begin this year? It is not too late. Hallelujah. It is not too late. It is very early in the morning.
We are in a seventh week of the year, and of the month. Let us make a decision of agreeing with God for the terms and conditions that the Lord will going to give for you to walk with Him. Number three, walking with God means that you are in His Spirit. Wakikuyu tunaimba ya kwamba dediyaga, dede ine waroho, inaoyaga, eni kakenaga, dede ine waroho, kodonewe. That in everything that we are doing, we do it in truth and in Spirit. Praise the Lord. For you and I to walk with God this year, unless we invite the Holy Spirit of God to walk with us, no way you'll be able to know the will of God. No way you'll be able to know and even to test how good our God is. Unless you and I, we invite the Spirit of God to be with us in order to guide us, in order to lead us, in order to give us a wise counsel. Praise the Lord. Number four. Walking with God means that you choose. It is a matter of choice. Amen? Joshua tells the people of Israel, if serving God seems undesirable to you, my family and I have come up with my decision that the next part of my life, I will be serving the Most High. Amen. Hallelujah. Joshua made a decision that touches his family. You as a Christian, you as a parent, we need to walk with God in our family, in our place of job, in your businesses, in your spiritual life, in your social life, in your life. We need to walk with God and we need to make a right decision. Make a choice to walk with God. Joshua made his choice that I will walk with God. And by making the choice, Paul, in the book of Romans chapter 12, he said, sacrifice your body as a living sacrifice. And to give your body fully to God as a living sacrifice. Are we going to offer ourselves fully to God as a living sacrifice? Praise the Lord. Ama ni kuna kitu ambacho tutabakisha ndani yetu. Maybe hicho utabakisha, ndicho kitakufanya, kitamfanya Mungu asiandamane na wewe. We need to offer ourselves fully to serve the Lord. The Bible says, and it's the great of all commandments. And when we walk, let those commandments very clearly that we need to love our God with all our mind, with all our soul, with all our heart, with everything that pertains to us. We need to commit ourselves fully to God in order to give ourselves to God as a living sacrifice. And that is why the Bible says, after doing so, after offering yourself to God as a living sacrifice, now test the will of God and you see how good God is to you and I in our life. Praise the Lord. Walking with God, number five, means that you will display a fruit of spirit. That you have the fruit of the spirit in you. And as it is well stipulated, in Galatians 5, verse 23. That you'll be able to bear the fruit. Last year our theme was bearing the fruit that we give you last. And since we bear that fruit, we continue bearing that fruit so that the Lord may continue walking with us in our life. And by bearing the fruit, you will be able to live the life that is so different with the other people that are surrounding you. And the surrounding people, those are surrounding us, they will have a testimony that I have not seen someone else who is faithful, who is a Christian, who is upright, like so and so, because of bearing the fruit that you rust. Number six, walking with God is to choose glorify the Lord, is to choose glorify the Lord in every way we can, regardless of our personal life. Regardless, those who are surrounding you, they are saying what? Regardless, they are talking about you or about what? It is good that we choose to glorify God, because that is how we need to walk with God. As I finish, walking with God requires what? Walking with God requires righteousness. And righteousness is the purity that is coming inside, and it reflects outside. Not the uriya mundu agikuona, not only the physical appearance, no. It is what is coming from inside. So, walking with God requires righteousness. Number two, walking with God requires faith. And if you read in the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, you are going to see so many people there. They were regarded by God as good people because of their faith. So, walking with God requires faith. Walking with God requires that uprightness, in your life, which is the virtue of a true believer. Uprightness is the virtue of true believer. Enoch walked with God uprightly and lived abundant life. Walking with God requires humility. Remember in the book of Peter, the Bible says, God hates the proud, but he gives his grace to the humble. And number five, walking with God requires total commitment. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the Lord help us walk with him in the course of the year.